Hi everyone. Well, I'm out here in the garden working again this morning. Thought I would bring you along as I do a little bit of work to my mint plant. Now, I absolutely love fresh mint. If you grow mint, you know how it has that fresh, delicious flavor. It's really fun to add it to water with like a watermelon, a couple slices of watermelon, and I absolutely love it in mojitos. But I'm gonna trim it up today. Thought I would bring you guys along and share with you a couple of my favorite mint growing tips. But first, let me show you where I have my mint plant. You guys have seen this little garden bed on a lot of my videos, and I'm really happy with how it's coming along right now. The weather's finally starting to cool off a bit, so I've got my nasturtiums here, which are just going crazy with the cool weather. Got my strawberry towers, which you guys have seen on a lot of my videos. Nice little eggplant still going here. Some oregano, and back there is my mint plant. One thing about mint, if you've ever grown it, you know that it's super invasive. So let me go around here to the back of the plant, to the back of the planter, give you a little bit of a closer look at the mint plant. And I do like to grow it in a container, and that's actually one of the first tips I want to tell you about is make sure you put it in some kind of a container or contained area, because if you don't, it will literally just take over wherever it's planted. So I really feel like that's important to get it in a container, which I do have here. I do want to trim this back today, and that's one of the reasons why I'm doing this video. Now, the second tip that I like to do with mint is to trim it regularly. Let me get a little bit closer here, and you can see starting to develop some little seed pods. Let me find one here. Okay, you can see that there. Starting to flower, go to seed. Now the flowers are really pretty. I don't think any are flowering right now, but it's kind of a little purple flower. The bees really do like it, but I am gonna trim this back today because if these actually start dropping in the garden, I'm gonna have little mint sprouts absolutely everywhere in here, which I don't want. So I'm gonna trim it back, show you guys how I do that, and then come back and just share with you one other little tip at the end. So let me just show you how far over the top of the container this mint plant has grown. So I'm just gonna trim it back so it looks a lot neater and tidier, gets rid of some of those seed pods. Now, the nice thing about mint is it might look extreme when you're cutting it back, but it grows so, so fast. I can't even tell you how many times I have cut this mint plant back to where there is nothing left in this container except some woody stems, and it has grown back. It's actually a perennial in zones, I believe it's zones 4 through 9. So if you live in one of those zones, you can pretty much grow it from year to year. And it will grow for you all winter long. Another good reason to trim my mint plant is it's starting to get a little bit woody. The leaves are like a little bit smaller than I would like. I really want some nice big leaves. So trimming it back will give it a nice little burst of energy when it regrows, and it should regrow with nice big leaves for me, which are always nice for that mint tea or those mojitos. Okay, well, my mint plant has its hair cut here. You can see I cut it pretty far back to these woody stems. Now, I know it looks drastic. I know it doesn't look nice and full like it did before. Cut off a lot of the seed pods, gave it a nice little trim across the top. But this will result in new growth that's gonna be larger leaves, tastier leaves. It's gonna look prettier in the long run. So plants don't always look great when you prune them, but it's actually better for them in the long run. Now, winter and fall is really a perfect time to trim mint. Cut it right off. It'll overwinter just fine in zones 4 through 9. And then in springtime, you're gonna get some nice new leaves, and it's gonna be a really nice herb for you to grow in your garden. Now, what to do with everything I trimmed? Let me show you the big bucket I have here. Okay, this bucket is pretty much full of all the trimmings, but I'm not going to compost them because I do not wanna take the risk of the mint spreading to the rest of my garden. But I'm also not gonna throw them away. I'm gonna give some away to friends. I'm also gonna save it and put it in a big vase of water, because on Saturday, we're having a party at our house, and I'm gonna take this and infuse it with some watermelon. I'll clean it up first, infuse it with some watermelon, some fruit. It's gonna make a really, really good infused water. So that's gonna be a lot of fun, but that also brings me to my third tip. If you need some more mint plants, the only thing you have to do is take a little sprig, put it in a jar of water, and it is going to sprout roots within a couple of days. Mint is so easy to propagate. So if you want to give some to friends, that's a great way to do it. If you want to plant some more in containers, just root it, put it in a container, and you're going to be all set. Well, there you have it. Three of my favorite tips for growing mint. Grow in a container, give it a haircut, and propagate it by rooting it in water. And if you follow these tips, you're sure to always have lots of mint in your garden. Now, I also wanted to ask you what types of videos you'd like to see here on my channel this winter. So comment below, let me know. I'd love to hear your feedback. And I hope you enjoyed spending time out here in my garden with me today. I know I really enjoyed spending it with you. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Bye-bye. See how easy that was to cut when it's nice and cooked as opposed to when it's raw? Wow, look at that gorgeous orange flesh. Oh my gosh, I just love it.